a home for the Suppressed Histories Archives. After flying without a net for 48 years, it is time to put ground under our feet and for the future of the Suppressed Histories Archives. I have been working extremely hard to get a down payment together for the house where the archives lives with Nava and me, and where it grows every day. I work on it every day. This house that we're in now is the right place for the archives to be safeguarded. In 3+ years, I have managed to get together 2/3 of the down payment, but I need to make the buy soon while interest rates are low. This will save tens of thousands of dollars over the long haul. Gentrification is moving fast, and time is of the essence to finalize the buy before the interest rates go up. The Suppressed Histories Archives is a collection of images, slides, hard copies, and digital, research texts, articles, visual talks, and videos. Over the years, most of the work I've done has been unpaid. I've answered hundreds of queries, if not thousands, without asking for compensation, because I believe that the information is important, it must be known, it must be shared. And countless women and some men have told me how important the work of the archives is and how there is really nothing quite like it. Women from many different ethnic backgrounds and countries have come to me looking for the free women in their roots, their heritages, seeking sources and resources. This fundraiser is to raise the final third of the $60,000 down payment and closing costs for the house where the archives lives. If more can be raised, we might be able to avoid paying mortgage insurance, which is for the bank, not for us as first-time homebuyers. It is commonly required from low-income people. But once 20% of the principal is paid, I'm told, mortgage insurance is no longer required. The more of the principal we can pay down now while buying, the more secure the archives that we hold space for will be. This is not easy for a feminist who has functioned at the margins of the economy for my entire adult life, for a working class woman, independent scholar, especially getting a mortgage loan. Because the bulk of my work has been unpaid, I will receive very little in Social Security and have no retirement account, no cushion. I've put everything I have and many, many years of solid work into the archives. So I am not going to retire, but I plan to continue this work all my life. And my goal is to pay down the principal on the house as rapidly as I can, so that when I turn 80 in 13 years, I can afford the monthly mortgage payments. The long-term plan for the archives is to continue in this house after I'm gone as a public resource. I have no heirs. This heritage belongs to all women and all people. The archives receives no funding other than what I'm able to earn and the occasional donation. No institutional support of any kind. We're in the process of applying for a 501c3 nonprofit status and eventually be able to take tax-deductible donations, but that will take a while, and this house buy needs to happen in the next few months. Up until now, I have shouldered sole responsibility for the costs of housing the archives, paying all the web hosting fees, all expenses involved in archiving files, slides, digital media. And so it's time now to crowdsource some of those expenses. I'm paying rent on a bigger place just to house all the many file cabinets and light table and slides and all the equipment, the flat files and everything, so that I'm freed up to pour out the resources I've gathered over the decades and pouring them out in the form of books and videos and web pages and articles and all the resources that some of you already know. I'm trying to keep this fundraiser as simple as possible, and so I'm not offering premiums this time. If you would like books, and I have several that you're seeing here right now, posters, DVDs, or prints, ordering them from Valletta Press increases the income stream that I'm already using to raise the down payment. And so those purchases do contribute to the goal, as also do subscriptions to my online course, Treasures of Women's History, which is really like a Patreon for the Suppress Histories archives, and also by subscribing to the individual webcasts. This time I'm asking for donations, plain and simple. The premium is the work itself and the body of resources that I'm assembling digitally in visual talks and videos like the ones you're looking at here in the articles, the books, the posters. And another thing that's happening is web pages. This year, I'm going to begin adding 8,000 pages of new content to the Suppress Histories site. And this is harvested off the last 8 years of Facebook posts. And they're being run through a database and creating web pages, all of which require the labor of adding navigational pages so that you can find your way to them on the Suppress Histories site as the categories of healers, priestesses, medicine women, goddesses, women warriors, class conquest, all of the various categories. And so those navigational pages have to be created, and ultimately tags for everything, for all the content, hyperlinking it all so that the site will be fully searchable and you'll be able to find the content you're looking for. So this is a really important step in making the entire site a resource, open source font for this information, these images, the archaeological information that is so often sequestrated so that you can't get at it. It's too hard to find it. It's hidden. Historical information, orature, many different angles. And so if you can contribute $500 or $1,000 or more, that would really help. But smaller donations, many of them put together, also add up. And I'm also asking, usually my donors are women. Overwhelmingly, the support has come from women, but I'm also asking conscious men to see the value of the archives and to make donations that reflect their support. Because this is much of this, you know, this is global spiritual philosophy. It's world heritage. It is what we need to know in order for humanity to recalibrate and to get a grip on who we really are, and understand the underpinnings of domination and also the precious cultural heritages that exist that show us another way than what we're suffering under right now. And so I hope you find all of this of value, and if you do, that you will contribute accordingly. The names of all donors, except for those who want to remain anonymous, will be gratefully acknowledged and published on the Suppress Histories site, and you know, I'll figure out how other ways of doing that. It's really important for this fundraiser to be shared on social media, whether it's Facebook, Twitter, or whatever, and with your network of friends. If you have a mailing list, any groups that you have on Facebook or whatever form it is, just to be able to get the word out about this. It really needs to be crowdsourced, because this is something that ordinarily, you know, libraries have institutional support. All of this is an act. It's a insurgent women's history project that does not get that kind of institutional support. And frankly, has been struggling precariously all these 48 years on a shoestring. And it really slows everything down. It's, you know, I have to make the rent every month, and then it'll be the mortgage, probably more than the rent. And so this is all just to say that getting that part covered or getting some security for the future so that I can continue doing this work and not having to go back and to elder care or some other hustle to pay those expenses and continue to house the archives and to do the work, you know, just to be freed up enough to actually get that formatting of the website so that it really has an international audience. I don't know if people understand The Suppress Histories page on Facebook right now is up to about 164,000 people are following it. And they're from countries like Iran and Brazil and India and places, Taiwan, Saudi Arabia. I'm getting hits from all over the place. And so it really is an international resource for women, for anyone interested in cultural studies. And the powers that be won't support this. It's going to have to be us. So I thank all donors, all of those who share this fundraiser and help boost the signal, so that these stories that we need to understand can be told, you know, in the dire times that we're in right now. And, you know, that pushback is there. We are fighting back, and we're going to find ways to overturn these structures of domination. We have to. This is like the 11th hour, the 59th minute of the 11th hour, to bring forward that spirit of justice and compassion that is so needed. Reverence for the earth, cognizance of our ancestral heritages. So we need our history. We need to know the images of our history, of women's history, which has been omitted and deleted, especially the global aspect of it. So I'm asking for your support. Please donate. Please share. Thank you.